Welcome back to another episode on the Lake Laogai server. Yay! So today, we are back in my base. And as you can see behind me here, I've done some small things off camera here. Just, you know, small little decorative thing. I thought I'd put another house up and stuff like that. So yeah, and I did some little bits and pieces of landscaping as well around here. No. I'm lying. I'm sorry. This isn't my base. I guess I'm a bit pretty bad actor, so you probably realize this by now. But yeah, this is not my base. This is built by a very old member called Schmogel. Schmogel? Schmogel? Schmoo? Shmoo. Something like that. Someone I have never seen online at all. So pretty much long gone before I joined this server. So yeah, I have never met the person, but this place is really, really cool. So thought I would just start over here for some reason. Don't think I'm going to go tour the whole thing too much, but man, just a beautiful backdrop to my intro. It's pretty much what I thought. So this episode today is going to be a little bit of... this is such a cool place, by the way. this is going to be... pretty short one, I think. Just a couple of things I want to talk about, and probably just gonna look at a couple of things and yeah, stuff like that. So nothing special about this at all. I mean, I could go and make a bunch more like tour episodes and stuff, but nah. You have to go check out the other people, pretty much. If you want to see what they are building or what they have done, you need to go check them out. I mean, I've showed off pretty much me and Para switched, so we did a tour of each other's spaces, which I think is a good thing. So if you want to see what I've been up to, go check out Para's channel. And then last episode where I went around and looked at some stuff that haven't been built on camera. Can I jump over there? Yes, of course I can. Which I think is a nice thing. I don't know if this has been recorded or anything. I have no idea. But yeah. The rest of the stuff, or there's a lot of stuff that people have built here, but they have been built on camera. So if you go check everyone out, you will see what they have been up to, I think. That's a pretty cool looking crane there. This is actually pretty close to my base. I think my base is over in that direction somewhere, maybe. Yeah. When I was looking for an area to build, I was kind of looking around the shoreline here, and I found a nice spot, I think over there or something, and then I went just around the corner, and this place was there, so I had to go find somewhere else, or if it was over in the dark oak forest over but in that direction. I don't remember. It's a long time ago. Or something like that. Yeah, so what do I want to talk about today? This episode here, feather falling. You don't mind feather falling one. This episode today is going to be my last episode, at least for now, from this server. Because we are starting the new server. Yay! Which is a little bit exciting and all that. So, I want to get up there. I can't. No, I can't. Yeah, so... first of all, I want to thank everyone for watching my content. I've produced, I think, this is episode 52, I think, from the server. Which is quite crazy, if you ask me. I thought I was going to go maybe 20 episodes or something like that, I don't know, but... things got a little bit high pigment out of hand, and I managed to do a lot of stuff here, which, I mean, it's fun, and I've enjoyed every second of it, so yeah. So that's the first thing I want to say, is thank you so much for watching, and I really hope you will continue watching me in the future. I have some really, really crazy plans. What's down here? Item elevator? Yeah. Some crazy plans. I got sidetracked a little bit. which often happens when I just run around looking at things. I will try to do stuff that I haven't done on this server, or if I do kind of the same things, I'm going to try to make them differently. There are a couple of things that... a couple of forums, for example, that I never got around to do on this server, which is something that I want to do on the next one, and... some other things that I never got around to do, which starting all fresh, I will have all the time in the world to pursue like about projects words like that. So yeah, we'll see. Hopefully it will be something different and not just a repeat of everything I've done on the server, because that would be a little bit boring, I think. Yeah. So, yeah, I'm going to try to mix everything up. And just going to say this, like a little teaser, that episode 1 on the new server is going to be something very unique, I hope, at least. There are things being planned, and... if everything goes to plan, it's going to be a very unique first episode, I think. Ouch. That's not what I wanted to do. That's rails. And something, I don't know if I have ever seen that being done before, like... well, I guess I've seen it done before, but it's a very unusual way of starting off a server. Let's put it like that. Which I hope will be a ton of fun. So that's a thing to look forward to. And yeah, as I said, I have some plans for my base and some stuff like that. So and it's all a tiny bit crazy, at least. Yeah, I think I am going to fly over to my base real quick and see if there's anything over there we need to have a look at. This place is beautiful, by the way. So, we are back over in my base again, for real this time. I don't think I actually fooled anyone earlier. I really hope I didn't fool anyone. yeah, so, like, I wanted to reflect a little bit over what I've done so far on this. I'm probably not going to do, like, montages and stuff like that. I'm just going to talk a little bit about a couple of projects, I think. First of all, I set a goal for myself, quite a while back, actually. I didn't quite accomplish it. But I came pretty close, actually. My goal was to farm one of each beacon, if that makes any sense. So I wanted to make farms to get an iron beacon, a gold beacon, an emerald beacon, and a diamond beacon. Which, I mean, I got the iron, gold, and emerald. I've got, it's the diamond beacon that's a little bit trickier because that depends on other people as well. So, I mean, the iron one, obviously the iron farm, the gold one is obviously the ghast and gold farm. The emerald is, I count the emerald factory for that. I can trade for emeralds over there. I haven't actually built the beacons, but I do have the resources to trade for enough emerald blocks to make a full beacon. When it comes to diamonds, I'm like halfway there. What is it, 2 stacks 36 or something you need? So I'm halfway there, and that one is a little bit trickier because it kind of relies on building shops and stuff and selling things from your farm. So a lot of those diamonds I've actually gotten from my bookstore that I made a while back. Whee! I like this place. So, but, you know, with more time and stuff and with more active players here, I would definitely be able to do it. Maybe open up another shop or two or doing something like that to get the diamonds that way. But, yeah, with the new server coming, activities have gone down quite a bit on the server, which is totally understandable. So I haven't been able to do that. That's it's a shame, but I almost made it. when it comes to like what I've done, what I'm most proud of and stuff like that, I'm going to say the thing that I've done that is the most useful is my big smeltery that I built quite early on. Which helped me get the glass, for example, for the Ghast Farm and the Witherskelly Farm. That's a lot of glass going into that. And with this setup I have down here, it's... let's go down and have a look at it. This helps so, so much. If anyone have missed this, this is a 64 furnace array that I've set up down here. And it all goes up into a little input, and output chests are in the building up top there. So this is so fast, it's ridiculous, to be honest. Coal? Ooh, full of coal. That's good. So this is the most useful thing that I've built, and the thing that I'm actually the most happy with, because it's... It took some time to design this and come up with how I wanted to set this up. I used a bunch of pre-existing contraptions, pretty much, and put them all together into one machine. Or something like that, at least. So, yeah, this is probably the thing that I'm most happy about, or the thing that I've had... that has been most useful to me. And since it's sort of my own design, that's always a plus, always a plus. I really like the way the pub turned out. I think that is one beautiful, beautiful building. I really, really like that. It's got a lot of detail, but not too much detail to make it look busy. And yeah, I don't know. It's I think it's a gorgeous building. And also that tower. I'm very, very, very happy with that one. Oh, yeah. So those are probably my two favorite builds. Those are completely different building styles from each other, but well, not completely different, but you know what I mean. Or maybe you don't. I don't know. Yeah, distraction again. And I also like this build. Shush. It's a good building. It's a good building. It's a good building. I'm not gonna complain anything about that. I really like that one too. That turned out great. I'm not really disappointed or with any of my builds. I mean, the exterior of the smeltery house over there, I'm not too happy about that, to be honest. But it is what it is. I don't like this part up here. That's what I don't like about it. The rest of the building I think looks good. The interior I'm really happy with. And from this line here and down, I'm really happy with it. I don't know what I would have done or could have done differently. I don't know, but if I were to redesign this, it will look different. Kind of looks like Dark Helmet Man from Spaceballs. Old reference there. Maybe someone will catch that. And I'm really happy with the storage room down here. Let's go down to the storage room down here. I always get confused in here. This room I like a lot. This is so my building style. The floor is a bit strange with the different levels and stuff, but yeah. I still like this a lot. Turned out great. I am happy with this. Yeah. Other than that, I mean the Witherskelly farm, that was one crazy project and not something that I want to do by myself ever again. But I probably will. The whole slabbing is just so much work. But it's a fun little project, and the farm turned out really good and really efficient. So I'm happy with it. I'm really happy with it. And the ghost farm, it might be special and a crazy build for a lot of people, but that's think the third time I've built that farm. So to me, it's just I know what it is. It's nothing special. It's a very, very cool farm. But it's not like a big crazy project to me because I've done it a couple of times before, so might sound a little bit strange. Also the iron farm, that was a new one for me. I haven't built one of those before. I've tried to build an iron titan. Kind of failed a little bit twice before, but I haven't built any of this. Where are you? Here are you. Self stacking thingy designs before, so this thing was actually pretty simple to build, and it's working great. I'm really happy with this as well, but I mean, it's not my own design in any way. This is by Groova Guy. It's a 32 village iron farm, so it's very quick once you get it going, and yeah, pretty easy to build and very, very good. So I would recommend. Hi, guy. This video will come out, I think, a week from when I'm recording it, actually. But that's not what I wanted to say. What I wanted to say is the week after this video comes out, so the Saturday after this video comes out, we will do our first recording on the new server. Yay! And so that will be done on the 2nd of September, which should be a week after this one comes out. It should be. And then the first videos will roll out the Saturday after that, I think we decided. Because a lot of people here are, or all the people on the server are working, most people at least, are working full-time jobs or go to school or stuff like that. So we have limited time to record and edit and all that, so we want to give everyone a fair chance to release episodes at the same time, or episode one on the same day. So that's why we are giving us a week to do that, or at least I think so. That will be the 9th of September. You can expect to get a lot of new content from the people here, pretty much. Yeah. And then we will see. I will record. I have no idea about scheduling. I will do probably stick with the same thing I've done for this, which is one episode a week, and then bonus episodes if I happen to have them, which I've happened to have a lot of them on this server. So who knows? It might be the same on the next one, or it might be something different, but at least one video a week is my goal. But since this is the last episode from this server, and we will start recording next week and release videos the weeks after that. That means next Saturday I don't have any videos planned, actually. Unless I come up with something, I don't know, a little showcase of some redstone contraption or something like that. I have some ideas about that, but I don't know. But there might not be a video from me next week. And I hope you're okay with that. If not, that's too bad. Really nothing I can do about that, to be honest, because it will be too late probably once you see this. Enough rambling from Magoo, I think. So I really hope you have enjoyed watching my series from this server, and I really hope you will continue to watch me on the new adventures on the new server, which will be hopefully very exciting, hopefully something new and different from what I've done here, and all that. And hit the like button if you like this video, subscribe if you never want to miss one of my videos again. And as I've said so many times before, go check out the other people on the server as well. Links in the description. And I will see you on the other side. Bye!